Welcome to Wired Digitally. Today we are going to discuss about main method. First of all, what is mean by method? We have some, many people might be having some doubt. So what is mean by, method? Method means simple, guys, very simple. Method and function, according to C++, we are calling as a function. According to Java, we are calling as a method. That's it. That is, you know, big challenge here. Like, for example, public void hello. According to C and C++, it is calling as a function. Okay. According to C and C++, it is calling as a function. According to Java, it is calling as a method. That's it. Nothing else. Okay. Right. So I'm not going for in depth on that. So try to understand why it is coming, like why you are calling as a method. So in the next videos, I will give the more clarity on that. Okay, so come to our point. Main method is nothing but what? It is a one of the method. Okay, method means what? It should be contained. Any word, it should be contained, opening and closing bracket. Okay, then only it is calling as a method. Okay, so similarly, main method is also one of the method. Main method is also one of the method, okay? But here, we are going to discuss about how, what is the syntax of the main method, how it can be like all the modifiers are important. I will explain one by one, okay? So simple, this is my Java class. Might be everyone aware of that. So maximum people, like especially graduates, they have the very a small doubt. Simple, very small doubt. What is that doubt, sir? While compiling our Java class, is it required main method? Are you able to compile without main method my Java class? So many doubts are there for any maximum graduates, like engineering graduates, students. Okay, guys, simple. First of all, you have to know where the compilation starting from. Is it from main method? Like some people are thinking, sir, compilation and execution starting from the main method. No. The compilation always starting from packages. What is mean by package? Package is nothing but a header file according to Java. Sorry, C and C++. So according to Java, we are calling as what? Package. Okay. Compilation starting from the package, but the execution starting from the main method. Okay. Right. So now, why you are thinking, why the main method is required while compiling our source code? Not required, right? Okay. Now, without main method also, we can able to what? Compile our Java code. Okay. You can write any method, like for example, public void welcome method. So inside I written one statement, system.out.println welcome to Wired Digitally. Okay, that's it. Welcome to Wired Digitally, that's enough. This is a method, right? Even though without main method, we can able to compile our Java code. Okay, na? Without main method, we can able to compile. Please remember that. Okay. For example, see where you are located our Java code in the E drive. E drive. Let me go for E drive. Because I saved my Java code in E drive. Okay. Right. So that's what I moved to E drive. So compile. How to compile Java C test.java? We can able to compile. No worries. Not required the main method. But many people are thinking main method is required. Without main method, you can't compile. Who told? Who told? Without main method, we can able to compile. Okay, right. Compilation never starting from the main method. Sir, let me remove this method. Is it able to compile? Yes, it should be. It should be. No method is required here. No method is required while compiling our Java code. Try to understand. Please remember, this is the fundamental or this is the universal truth. While compiling the Java code, need not to required any, need not to require the main method. That's it. Okay, right. Sir, without main method, how it is compiling? Because that main method is coming to the picture at the time of executing our Java code. Am I right? While compiling, not required main method. Okay. So might be, let me give the one clarity here, guys. Okay. Compilation starting from where? Packages. Okay. Is there any package here? No. But one thing you have to remember. There is a one default package. You know, that package name called what? java.lang package. Lang stands for what? Language. This method, this package, by default it will be available. Okay, don't think too much. The compilation starting from the main method, it is starting from the packages. So there is no package, but there is a package. Okay, you have to remember that. All right, guys. Okay, let me go for the our main method concept. Okay, how to declare main method? Before that, according to C and C++, how many ways you can able to create the main method, main function? Is it valid or invalid? This is valid. Okay. Void main. This is also valid. Int main, this is also valid. Am I right? According to C and C++. But according to Java, these are not valid. All are invalid. Okay, these are valid up to only C and C++. These are all invalid according to Java. Okay, according to Java, what is the style of main method? Public, static, void, main, guys. Main, string, array, aux. This is the main method declaration. Okay, now guys. So if you want to write the main method in Java, you have to write like this. Don't change anywhere. Okay, right. So here, according to C and C++, the main method, main function, you can able to write in different syntax. Okay, all are valid, guys. Okay, let me jump to Java main method. Okay, right. What is mean by public? What is mean by static? What is mean by void? Like main is a main method. So why the string array is required? As an argument to the main method, why not other arguments like int array or character array or byte array? Why it is not? I will explain point by point, guys. Please remember. Please remember. So, why main method should be public? Okay, simply. So, to call by JVM from anywhere, to call by JVM. Anywhere. Okay, there is an access modifier. See, according to C and C++, access modifiers are different, access specifiers are different. But according to Java, there is no access specifiers. They all are considered as access modifiers. Those are private, public, default, protected, static, final, strict FFP, native, volatile, transient, abstract. These are all the modifiers, guys. There is no access specifier. Okay. Anyway, I will explain in the next videos, like what is the modifier, how many kind of what modifiers are there. So I will explain each and everything, guys. Don't worry about it. Okay. Right. Listen carefully. So now, public is what? Access modifier. What is the purpose of the public here? To call by the JVM from anywhere. Okay. Suppose that I don't want to declare my main method as public. I want to declare as a private. Okay. Right. Try to understand. So my main method is not a public. Just I created as a private. Guys, before declaring or before using private modifier, what is the significance of the private modifier? What is the scope of the private modifier? The private modifier is the scope of what? Within the class, outside the class cannot be accessed. It cannot be useful. It won't be work here. So, anyway, let me try. Let me change. Why? The main method is always public. Why not it is private, right? Okay. Let me give the clarity of that. Okay. So again, compilation. At the time of compiling, main method is not required. But he written the main method. Okay. But it is not proper way. You have to remember that one. Okay. So okay, let me compile. Valid. If you did any changes in the main method, you won't be getting any compile time errors here. But you are getting runtime errors at the time of executing. How you are executing? Java, our class. See, error, main method not found in class test. Why this is blindly coming? There is a main method, right? But again, why it is showing error? There is a problem here. You have to understand. See, you have to read the error first of all. Error. Main method not found in class test. But there is a main method. Okay. No doubt about it. You already written the main method. Okay. Again. Please define main method as what? Okay. Please define main method as what? Public. Static void means something else. Okay. You have to concentrate right now. Public. Okay. So, why you are getting the runtime error? Why it is showing like this? Because the JVM is always looking for what? The main method should be public. But what modifier you are used here? Private. Is it valid? At compile time, it is valid here. At the runtime, it is invalid, right? So, that's what you are getting the error. Error main method not found in class test. Please define the main method as what? Clear? Okay, guys. Okay, let me remove the private. Let me write the protected. Is it valid? Compile time it is valid here. No doubt at all. But at the time of executing, same error. You can read. Error main method not found in class test. Please define the main method as what? Okay. That is, private is invalid. Protected is also invalid. Okay. Let me remove. I don't want to provide anything here. No private, no protected. If you didn't mention any modifier, what modifier is applicable here? Default. Okay. Right. Let me compile. No compile time errors. But at the time of executing, see. Error main method not found in class test. Please define main method as what? You tell me. Main method private? No. Protected? No. Default? No. But that should be what? Come on, guys. Okay. main method should be public. Yeah. Why it is public? Why not private? Why not protected? Why not default? Why not some other modifiers? Simple. If you declare the main method as a private, what is the scope of the private within the class? Na? But I created like 10 classes. Out of the 10 classes, one class only have the main method. Rest of the 9 classes, there is no main method. But my main method should be access all 9 classes methods into the 10th class. How it is access? It should be in a position to access, right? So if we want to access the 9 class methods into our 10th class, then main method should be public, right? The public means it should be available for all classes. That's why main method should be public but not private. Private scope is what? Within the class. What is the scope of the protected? Protected, same, it is a package level modifier. Okay, same package of the all classes, next package of the derived class. There is a, some restriction also na, in the protected. What is the default? The default scope is what? Say whole package. That to the same package. Other package classes, it won't be accessed. But all classes, like whatever you discussed, the example, 10 class methods, all are designed different packages. You tell me, if you declare the main method as a private, there is no use. Because that accessing is what? Within the class, right? Protected. Same package of the all the classes, next package of the derived class. There is a restriction also. Parent class, it won't be accessed. That's why protected also is not fit for main method. And default scope is what? So whole same package. Rest of the packages, it won't be accessing, right? Default not required. Default also is not recommended to use. Private also, it is not recommended to use. And a protected also, it is not recommended to use. Which one is the recommended to use? Only public. Right? Main method should be what? Public. So if you change anything as a private, as a protected, as a default, anything, we won't be getting any compile time errors, guys. We are getting at runtime errors only. Okay? Right. I hope you are understanding. Right? Okay, guys. Come to the static. Static means what? It is also one of the modifier, right? So the static without existing object also, JVM has to call this method. Without existing object, JVM also it has to call. But here, I don't want to provide, I don't want to declare my main method as a static. Try to understand. I don't want to declare my main method as a static. Just public void main method string arguments. Is it valid? Yes. At compile time, it is valid. Okay, now guys. At the time of executing, read the error. Error, main method is not static in class test. Tell me here. Main method should be what? Static. Main method, but here, main method is not static in class test. Please, requesting JVM here. Okay, please define the main method as what? Okay. Sir, what is the significance of this static? Simple. The static purpose, will give the more clarity in the going forward. Static is a modifier. What is the purpose of the static? You know, to provide some global behavior, some common functionality. For example, let's say one layman example, there is a university here. Under the university, maybe let's assume 100 colleges are affiliated. 100 colleges are what? Affiliated. Whatever the rules and regulations are passing to the each and every college, that should be followed. Am I right? So who is the boss right now? For all colleges, university is the boss. Okay. Don't create 100 classes university variable as instance variable. Okay. That should be declared as what? Yeah, static. Static means what? It is common. It is providing commonality or it is providing global behavior. See, according to C and C++, to provide the global behavior or global variables, because there is a possibility to create. How? Has to define. Am I right? Has to define some pi equal to 3.14 something. Am I right? This is what global variable. But according to Java, there is no global variable. But if you want to get the global behavior, it should be declared as what? Static. Sir, why it is the static? The main method should be created as a static, you know, as we discussed it. Out of the 10 classes, you have the main method only one method, one class na. So if you want to access the 9 class methods, in different, they are located in the different packages. But this class should be common, right? That main method should be common, right? Okay. If you want to access, that should be contains what behavior? Global behavior. If you want to get the global behavior, that method should be created as what? Static. Public purpose is what? For accessing. Static purpose is what? To get the, some global or commonality. Okay, I hope you got the clarity, guys. Void. Let me go for the third one. Void. Void is what? It is one of the return type keyword. Okay, return type keyword. See, why main method should be create as a void? Why not int? Why not float? Why not character? Why not byte? Why not signed? Why not boolean or something else? Why not string, something else? Reason. Main method could not return any value. Okay, that's what the main method should be created as what? Void here. It should be created as a void. It won't entertain anything. For example, as discussed, 10 classes are there. This is the 10th class. 9 class methods are there na. Okay, 9 class methods. The first class may be returning the integer data. Maybe the second class may be returning the float data. The third class may be returning the character data. The fourth class may be returning the boolean data. So each and every class are returning the different data types or different data. Okay. Suppose if I declared my main, maybe my main method return type may be int. Okay, then what is the problem here? You know, our main method should be written always what? Integer type of data. It is ignoring what? Rest of the data type. Am I right? You have to think about it. So let me compile. Is it valid or invalid? Pakka invalid. Reason. Other than the void, if any method may be containing other data types as a return type, should be provide the return statement. Should be provide what? Return statement. Return what? Zero. What is the default value for integer? Zero. Okay, now guys? Okay. Right. Okay. Otherwise, you are getting the compile time error. This is the syntactical mistake here. Okay? It should be written. Compile. What is that? Error main method must return a value type what? Type what? Void. In class test. Please define main method as what? Public static void. But not int, but not float, but not boolean or anything. Okay, na? For example, take one layman example, maybe if you have brother, two brothers for your parent, okay, you are the two brothers, you have, okay, your parents are the two kids, both are males. Up to some time, maybe college days, everyone, maybe both of you, you can spend your parent money. So after got married both, while distributing your assets and liabilities, maybe your brother got the 5% extra than you. Okay, the third world war may be starting from your home only. Absolutely correct. Because maybe as you have the some relationship now, your brothers, okay, might be your compromise. But the sisters are coming. They won't be compromised here. Okay, they will start world war, third world war. We have to remember. Vice versa, maybe elder son maybe got the 10% extra than elder younger son. Okay, then there also problem, right? That's what the parents should be share whatever they have the assets and liabilities equally. Otherwise, they start the third world war from your home. 100% pakka. Okay, come to the concept. So main method should not return anything here into flow to character, string, boolean or anything. It won't be written anything, because the main method is what? The big boss, no one at a time, any kind of data it should be come, but it won't be at a time. That's what it should be. Why? Okay now guys. Okay, as of now we discussed about what public main method should be, always what public and should be static, should be written type is what void only, but not other data types. Okay, next one, main method having some argument here. What type of argument? String array arguments. Why main method is always having the string array arguments? Why not int array? Why not character array? Why not byte array? Okay, let me change. No worries. Okay, int array args. What array you are passing as an argument? Int array, but not string array, right? Okay. Are you getting any compile time errors, sir? No. We never get any compile time. But at the time of executing, same problem. Error, main method not found in class test. Please define main method as what? Public static void main string array, but not int array, but not character array, but not other array. Okay now guys, okay. You have to remember always what string array. Sir, might be have the one down. Sir, why Java people blindly fixed the main method argument like a string array? Why not others? Reason, while filling the form here, maybe naukari registration or maybe Gmail registration or something, any registration. Okay, you are passing different data, right? You are passing int data. You are passing long data, you are passing character data, you are passing boolean data, you are passing string data. So all mix up, right? Okay. So by default, please remember this. Please remember, by default, Java, it can be take all kind of data, whatever you are passing here, int pass, boolean, character, signed or unsigned, or maybe long or double or float, anything, by default it will be take as a string. Okay, all data it should be placed in the string array. Okay, please remember that. That's what string array. If maybe it is make it as an int array, it is only allows the int data, right? maybe character array, character that it is allows. Maybe byte array, it is always at the allows the byte. It won't be allows other than those data types. If you want to support all kind of data types, main method should be contains the argument type as what? String array. Okay, guys. Sir, can I change the brackets? Okay. String complete. I hope you got, you are following. Right? Right. Array. Sir, can I declare after the args array symbol? Yes. No problem. You won't be getting any compile time error or runtime exception here. Simple. It is valid. You can. Sir, can I place here in front of the args? Valid or invalid? Pakka valid. Don't worry. Okay. Guys, if you have these kind of doubts, please fresh up your arrays comment. Okay? Right. Sir, can I place prior to string? Okay. Is it syntactically mistake or not? Please think about yourself. Syntactical mistake here. Compiler is ready to give the left and right like anything. Am I right? Syntactical mistake here. Okay. Right. So, we can place here. No problem. Before the data type, don't give the arrays. Sub square brackets. Okay. What about args? Args is the variable of what string array? Args stands for arguments. Instead of that, can I give some via digitally? Valid or invalid? Via digitally. Via digital is a valid one. Okay, don't think too much. It's pakka valid. Check it out. In the runtime also, you won't be getting any compile time. The compile time or runtime exception. Okay, it's pakka valid. But here, if you give the space between via and digitally, compiler again give the left and right like anything. Syntactical mistake here. What you are doing? Okay. Are you declare the variable like this? If you have the more than one word, but don't give the space between one word to another word. This is the problem. Okay. Right. Thank you. Okay. There is no space between via and digital. Both are. If you have the more than one word, you can use as a stringy array variable. But don't give the space between one word to another word. This is the fundamentally you have to understand. Okay. Right. This is about main method. Okay. Right. Thank you guys. Thank you one and all. Okay. We'll see more videos in the next session. Thanks.